Happy midweek build to everyone out there. Today we're going to be building up a fun, quirky one, an easy break, a very easy kit to put together, I'm going to assume, because it only has 46 parts in the box. This is Tom Daniel's Sidewinder custom show rod. It was sent over by Modelroundup.com. They have this in stock at this moment, so I will link down in the description. You won't be able to miss it. You don't have to wait for it to come in stock like so much other stuff I build on here. This one is ready to go. It is a pretty cool kit. It's been reissued by Atlantis. It's in 1/24th scale. It's got an inline six engine, which is very unique for a lot of these kits. I know like the Red Baron, I think, has an inline six as well. But a lot of them, you know, these hot rod kits are all blown V8s and all that kind of stuff. I love the quirky ones. It's got this cool snake detail being the Sidewinder. So it's got some awesome decals. It's got some scales. It's molded in tan and gold. I love the snakehead look on it. We're going to be checking out all the stuff in the box. First, we'll touch off on the side stuff. We've got a sweet set of decals here. Sidewinder logos, pure snake oil. I love the scales. Follow those directional arrows, or the scales should just aim towards the back like they do on a real snake. We've got extra pieces here. We've got Atlantis logos, Tom Daniel logos, and something I always think is funny because I mispronounce stuff all the time. It's Tom Daniel, not Tom Daniels. There's no S on the end of the name, so that should know that. Sidewinder custom show rod. I like these decals right here. Why? Because they make the step plates and you don't have to paint those on. Just another cool feature on this decal sheet. Now, my experience with Atlantis decals is they are very thin, they come off the backing paper easily, and they are also strong and flexible. So we shouldn't have any issues laying as many of these down as we want on the model. We've got a clear parts tree, rear windows, love that hexagon shape, and a front windshield. The windshield frame is slightly raised around the edge, so we should be able to detail that, and those castings are very, very clear. We've got a set of big and little tires. These are Goodyear Rallies. There is a name on them. Goodyear Rally tires. Black wall on the other side. Nice tread pattern to them. We can try to sand that down since they are quite exposed. And they are solid all the way through, which allows us to attach our wheels and wheel backs separately. And we don't have to glue anything together. And they'll hold tight. Being older molds, there is some flashing on these tires. Just use your razor knife. Cut those clean. On the outside where the name brand is, I don't see any such flashing. We've got a really cool copper colored chrome. So it's like a rose, it's a reddish copper style color. I'm digging it. It's not gold like the box top. You can see that it ended up being a more reddish chrome. It's very cool. We got the headers here, which have the heat fins. We can do some black washing in the cylinder heads and the carburation. We got a differential with a differential cover that has the heat sinks molded in. Here is our dashboard, belt and pulley system. We've got our suspension all rigged in, and those sweet custom tri-spoke wheels with wheel backs that resemble brake drums. I think that's really cool. And that color is definitely going to stand out on the model. Going to the other side of the table, and yes, I'm still getting over that bad cold. We've got a nice seat. We can see on the box art, they've got it painted. Everything else is molded in tan. We've got our straight six engine. We've got the snake's tongue. We've got some detail pieces for the backs of the seats. We've got our floor pan here. This goes under the engine. It's kind of be your chassis somewhat. You can see where all that's going to mount. Both sides, there's a little bit of flash on the engine. Once again, they invented these lovely things called razor knives. You can just take it and remove it. We'll do it right on camera, some of it. You see how easy that comes off? Nothing to worry about, nothing to get upset about. We've got our cool fenders here. We can see if you want to paint in the step plates, but I'm going to use those awesome decals. They should sink into that texture very well. You could even do some exterior detailing on the fenders add a little bit more detail around the edges. We've got the top of our cab, where our rear windows will go in. And we've got our chassis. You can see the engine sticks out somewhat out the side. We've got all these louvers built in, molded in. You could try to open those up a little bit, or you could mark them a little wash in there, make them look like they're open vents. That's going to be kind of neat. Going to have to decide how to do all this stuff. We've got our little snake head coming out. We just have to install the bottom. Pretty cool looking ride. So I'm going to start gluing all my stuff together. I will be back in just a moment.
Thank you.
After what can only be described as a momentary assembly process, there really is nothing to it. I did, in fact, did more than I would even need to by gluing the top of the body on. The reason I did that was I want to get it all painted together, you know, how it looks on the box and everything, but I wanted to make sure I could still get the seat in. And after I glued it on there and cleaned up the molding on the seat, that's why I showed you in the video that I can still slide that inside and I'll still be able to get the dashboard in place, and that's all we need to worry about the interior. So now that I know I can do that, I don't have to worry about joining this nice seam here at a later point and using super glue and ruining my paint job and stuff. It'll be easier to paint the body all in one. I also test fit the bottom of the body where the front axle mounts and the lower lip of the snake, and I tested that out, and that will pop in there, and I can glue that in with super glue, and it won't actually show that seam once it's together. So that will work out just fine. And the outer fenders that are here, I want to paint them body color, but they have this nice raised ridge, and on the box art it hasn't been touched, but I think that would be nice to accentuate that as well, that upper ridge. So I want to attach those later. They have large tabs on this, and those tabs correspond to these large placement areas here. There shouldn't be any issue with a drop of super glue holding that in place. It's not under tension or anything. It's not doing any of that. So that's my plan with those parts, and that's why I've built my model this way in particular. We've got the engine glued together, and then I cleaned it up and it looks lovely. So that'll be interesting. I'm going to think of a color for that engine. On the box art, it looks like it's black. I'll decide how I want to go with that. Also, on the headers, they are nice, but I'm going to have a lot of this copper chrome on the kit already. I mean, the front axle, the arms, the wheels, and all that stuff, and that I'm leaving alone. So these I want to do up in a different metallic tone, just to just distract a little bit, make it look nice. This is actually the drive shaft that goes into the differential back here, so we'll get that painted. This is the snake's tongue, of course. I want to paint that red, get that mounted up later. That actually will attach to this little pin here. When we put the kit together, the engine will mount here, and then it'll all raise in. If you decide you want to attach this now, you can also drop the engine in through that large opening at the top. Don't worry about it. It will go right down in without a problem. You're not going to have any issues with that fit on there. And then the belt and pulley system, I'm just going to paint that a standard color and do the pulleys in a different metallic color so that we can get it to stand out. That's it. The rest of these parts have large attachment points which will push fit in and then glue in. Gonna have to do some creative gluing with like the tie rod and stuff like that. Hopefully it'll fit in a little nicer. Otherwise, the cylinder, the valve cover, the carburation and all that, I want to hand paint the carburetors and detail it up my way. Probably hand paint the shock absorbers too, just so that we don't have so much of that chrome. The spoiler on the box is body color, but it's actually on the chrome tree. So if you want that to be body color, make sure you detach that, attach it to the body, and then paint it up. I think it'll look good all the way up on top with some of that, and maybe I can find a decal to place on top of that too. So I'm going to get everything into the paint booth. I've already washed the body down, the seat, the panel, and the fenders with some simple green. You can use Dawn dish soap, whatever you want, just so that we don't get any fish eyes in the paint, any oil residue from the molding process and whatnot. I'm going to get stuff primed, get it painted. I will see you over there. Another wacky show rod from the mind of Tom Daniel is done, brought to us by Atlantis Toy and Hobby, sent to the show by Modelroundup.com, who has this kit in stock. You can see how you can build this up. You can do box art. You can do your own version. You can just salvage all the parts from this to use in other kits. Those Goodyear rallies are pretty sweet, especially if you white letter them, like I showed you. We got that Pontiac Slant 6 underneath the hood, or not even underneath the hood, it's just bulging out the top. It's even got a hole in the bottom of the chassis so you can change the oil on it if you feel the need to. We got the sweet wheelie bars, because something this lightweight with that torquey inline six would definitely be able to pick the front tires up. Check out how beautifully the front suspension and steering go together. I wish kits that were deemed higher quality, people think, would go together that easy. I mean, the linkage in there and everything, and it goes together so easy, just plugs right in, glues in place, no fights, no fuss, no muss. The wheels push onto the axles, even when they're both covered in chrome, didn't have to shave anything down. The side fenders attach nicely, the seat goes in, the shifter, the steering wheel, the little mini dashboard inserts from the bottom. Everything fits nice on this kit, works nice, You can take it as far as you want. You can detail it the way that I have. You can go ahead and paint the body. You can detail the engine, paint some of the chrome work, change colors, make it stand out, make it your own, or leave it as it is, build it right out of the box. Out of the box, you'll get something extremely similar to what you see on the box. So you can do it any way you want. But the main way is that you have fun with your model kit. Don't let anyone tell you how to build. Don't let anyone tell you how to have fun, because that's what this hobby is about. And that's why I love building these oddball kits. We got the snake head on it. We got the tongue coming out. We got those nice decals. You saw how sweet the decals laid down, and you saw most of the assembly showing everything just really goes together easily. Then I dress everything up with future floor polish, which takes any clouding from glue away and brings the shine back from chrome. I want to thank Modelroundup.com for sending this over. I also want to thank Atlantis Toy and Hobby for buying all those old molds from Revell and reissuing all these sweet kits from back in the day that really were just languishing in warehouses and no one was ever going to touch them again. So, thanks for watching the workshop. We're almost to Christmas. We're going to have one more build done before Christmas, and then it will be time to have ham apocalypse, turkey time, whatever you want to do, as long as you're having fun. I will see all of you at the next review.